Shalom. First off, want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. And this is Shalom to all the Akim out here that's doing and pushing the work in truth and in sincerity. Okay? I want to go in this lesson. I'm going to title this video, Our Salvation is Nearer Than When We Believed. Okay? And, you know, pretty much, this is what we've been waiting for. You know, we're waiting for this salvation to come from the Most High, okay? From Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah, okay? And pretty much we see the prophecies coming to pass, okay? We see the mark of the beast is here, okay? It isn't mandatory yet. We see Donald Trump saying that, telling the police to not be nice to criminals and stuff, and you know they're already painting us as terrorists or whatever. Anyway, you know, even though we're not doing anything out here, you know, killing people and stuff like that, you know, we just preaching the word, okay? And the things that are in the scriptures, they're starting to come to pass, man. You know. But with that said, I'm going to start off with this scripture, Romans 13 and 11, and that knowing the time, okay, which the time is here, man, you know, we're in a serious time, okay, and it's not the time to be playing around, okay? You can read Ecclesiastes, the third chapter, okay, starting from the first verse. It says, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep, okay? And it's not the time to be trying to go back to college and get a degree and everything like that. The economy is crashing, okay? And you have a lot of these people that are really into the stock market and stuff, and they're saying that America, the stock market could crash in October, man. You know, and it could be one of the worst crashes ever, okay? Now you also have this thing with Russia where Putin just said that he's letting 775 diplomats leave from out of U.S. diplomats, I should say, leave from Russia, okay? So the time is here, man, you know, and pretty soon World War III is going to come, okay, and it's going to be a lot of chaos, man, when America collapses and everything, okay? It says, for now is our salvation nearer than when we believed, okay? And this shows you, ain't nobody saved yet, man, okay? Nobody is saved right now, okay? It's not no, okay, you die, and now all of a sudden, you get to go and join the kingdom before people that's out here right now. No, when the Lord comes back, okay, the people that are going to be saved are going to be the rulers of the kingdom of heaven, man. Okay? Alongside the one who the world ignorantly calls Jesus. Okay? The kingdom of heaven is going to be established here on this earth. Okay? Right now we're in hell, okay? And what we're waiting for, what we've been waiting for this whole time, is for this place to get destroyed, okay? This is Romans chapter 8, verse 24. For we are saved by hope, okay? We can't see that hope. We're not saved yet, okay? It says, but hope that is seen is not hope. Okay, and we've been hoping for the RFID chip to come to pass. Hey, we still hoping for it to come to pass, man. We still waiting for it. It didn't happen yet, but it's here. For what a man sees, why does he yet hope for? Okay, it says, but if we hope for that we see not, then do we with patience wait for it. Okay, and this is what we've been patiently waiting for, man. What's the word patience? Okay. I'm going to play the Greek.
Hupamane.
It says Hupamane, okay? And it says patience, enduring, patience, patient continuance, patient waiting, okay? Steadfastness, constancy, endurance, and we have to endure to the end. And this is what we've been enduring to, man. This is the final stretch, man. Okay, this is where the stage is already being set for Jacob's trouble. Okay, we've been waiting for this moment to start happening, man. A lot of spirits getting riled up. Judgment is coming. Okay, and judgment is being set on scoffers. Okay, the people that's been coming up against this word, it's going to be more to come, man. Okay, we're waiting and trying to get the hell up out of this society, man. We don't want to stay here. Okay, what's here, man? You know, yeah, another 5 years in America. That's a horrible way to think, man. You know, yeah, another year, another day. You know, we waiting for this thing to come to pass, man. You know, and if it don't come to pass, you know, in the next 6 months, a year, or whatever, and we still supposed to be waiting, okay? The scripture says that, you know, that patience tries our faith, man, you know? So, this is what we've been waiting for this whole entire time, man, you know? Lamentations 3:25, the Lord is good, Yahweh Bashem Yahushua is good unto them that wait for him. To the soul that seeks him, it is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. Okay? And what's that salvation? Okay? A part of it is America being destroyed. Okay? That collapse. Okay? That salvation is, you know, being delivered from the nuclear fire, the missiles. Okay? That's that salvation that we've been waiting for, man. Okay? That we've been, you know, putting in this labor, going out in the hot and the cold, you know. Even when it comes down to the apostles, you know, they've been doing this work for longer than a lot of brothers was born, man. You know? And hey, that 30 plus years, 25, you know, that's a long time, man, to be waiting, man. You know? And that's not something that should be taken lightly, okay? So for us brothers, man, you know, we see the stuff that's coming to pass right now, man, and the brothers, the apostles, they've been saying, the apostles and the elders, they've been saying this for a minute, man. You know? So you know they definitely waiting for it, man. You know? And it's crazy because, hey, the Lord is bringing this stuff to pass, man. You know? The word, the scriptures, you know, the mark of the beast, okay, the collapse and everything like that, it's all coming to pass, you know. I'm gonna get two more scriptures and I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna get three more. Psalm 62:5, my soul wait thou only upon Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, for my expectation is from him. Okay, and we don't expect America to come. We don't care about these checks that's coming and, you know, anything that comes with the society. It says, he only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense, and I shall not be moved. Okay? Psalm 62. Oh, that's the same scripture. Salakia. Luke 21:28. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption is not, okay? And we're not going to be saved with money or, you know, cars and all that stuff. You can't pay those things. The Lord don't require those things, man. You know, the Lord requires the ones that are faithful to him, okay? The ones that believe, the ones that kept his word, okay? And taught his word, okay? The ones that actually did the works, okay? Ultimately, we're saved by faith, you know, but the ones who by grace also, you know, the ones who are saved by the faith and the grace, you know, those are the ones who's going to be delivered, man, you know, and our deliverance is closer than what we think, man. A lot of these things are coming to pass, man, you know. And this is what we've been waiting for, man. So with that, you know, hopefully this is edifying, you know. I want to say shalom till next time.